Hello friends, now this is another lecture of linear partial differential equation with constant coefficient. Linear homogeneous partial differential equation, what is it? A differential equation where we differentiate a function partially with respect to any one function, any one variable, and taking another as a constant is known as partial differential equation. An equation of the form a naught del n z over del x raised to power n plus a 1 del n z over del x raised to power n minus 1 del y plus a 2 del raised to power n z upon del x raised to power n minus 2 del y square plus up to a n del raised to power n upon del y raised to power n equals to f x y is called linear homogeneous partial differential equation of nth order with constant coefficient, where a naught, a 1, a 2 up to a n are constants. So to solve it, we have to form auxiliary equation. And to form auxiliary equation, what we have to do? We have to put del over del x equals to capital D and del over del y equals to capital D dash. In equation number 1, what do we get? A naught d raised to power n plus a 1 d raised to power n minus 1 d dash plus a 2 d raised to power n minus 2 d dash square plus up to a n d dash raised to power n z is equals to f x y. To solve this type of equation, we have two functions. First, we have to find out from LHS, and the second we have to find out from RHS. From LHS, we have to find CF, complementary function. From RHS, we have to find particular integral. General solution is, that is GS, which is equals to CF plus PF. So in this lecture, we will study about CF only, and in the next lecture, we will study about PF. Okay? So, for CF, we are taking this particular equation a naught d raised to power n plus a1 d raised to power n minus 1 d dash up to a n d dash raised to power n dz. To find CF, we have to put d equals to m and d dash equals to 1 in the LHS of this particular equation number 2, then equate to 0 the bracket of LHS. So, what do we get? A naught m raised to power n, a1 m raised to power n minus 1, a2 m raised to power n minus 2 up to an, and which is equals to 0. That is, we have to put this entire bracket equals to 0 after putting d equals to m and d dash equals to 1. So this is a polynomial, and if there is any polynomial exists, then roots also exist. And if roots exist, then we have to calculate different conditions of CF. So first condition is, on solving we get roots. Then we have two cases. First case is when roots are distinct, say m1, m2 and m3, then CF is equals to f1 y plus m1x plus f2 y plus m2x plus f3 y plus m3x. Case 2, when roots are equal, that is m1 equals to m2 equals to m3, let it all these 3 are equals to m, then CF is equals to f1 y plus mx plus xf2 y plus mx plus x square f3 y plus mx. There are only these two cases to find the CF. Now we will solve some questions based on these two cases, then you can easily identify how to find the CF. Now we are taking one question. Solve d cube minus 4d square d dash plus 3d d dash square z equals to 0. So to solve it, what we have to do? We have to put d equals to n and d dash equals to 1 in the LHS of 1, then equate to 0 the bracket. So what do we get? m cube minus 4m square plus 3m is equals to 0. This is a cubic equation. And you all know how to solve a cubic equation, how to find the roots of this particular equation. We shall take m as a common. So m square minus 4m plus 3 equals to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation. And the solution of this quadratic equation, roots of this quadratic equations are 3, the factor of 3 as the sum of the factor of 3 are as the we shall take factor of 3 as the sum of 4 and the product of 3. So which are m minus 3, m minus 1 equals to 0. So we have m equals to 0, 1 and 3 all are distinct roots. So for these distinct roots we have CF is equals to, we shall apply this case number 1. So CF is equals to f1y plus m1x plus f2y plus m2x plus f3y plus m3x. So CF is equals to f1y plus 0x plus f2y plus 1x plus f3y plus 3x. Or we can write in the simplified form as f1y plus f2y plus x plus f3y plus 3x. So this is the solution of this type of problem. Now the another question is to solve del 2 z over del x square minus 4 del 2 z over del x del y plus 4 del 2 z over del y square equals to 0. So to solve this, first identify this type of equation is, this is a homogeneous linear partial differential equation with constant coefficient. The constants are 1, minus 4 and 4 and of order 2. So to solve this, first we have to put del over del x equals to capital D and del over del y equals to capital D dash. What do we get? D square minus 4 D into D dash plus 4 D dash square, z is equals to 0. Now for auxiliary equation, putting D equals to n and D dash equals to 1, then equate to 0, the bracket of LHS. So we get m square minus 4m plus 4 equals to 0. This is a quadratic equation. So on factorizing it, we get m equals to 2. The roots are equal. So CF is equals to f1 y plus mx plus x f2 y plus mx, or we can write CF equals to f1 y plus 2x plus x f2 y plus 2x. So this is the complete solution of this type of problem. Now we shall take one or two questions more. Now this is another problem. Solve the linear partial differential equation. Del raised to power 4z over del x raised to power 4 minus twice del raised to power 4z over del x cube del y plus twice del raised to power 4z over del x y cube minus del raised to power 4z over del y raised to power 4 equals to 0. This is linear partial homogeneous differential equation with constant coefficient of order 4. So to solve it, first we have to put del over del x equals to capital D and del over del y equals to capital D dash. So we get D raised to power 4 minus 2 D cube D dash plus 2 D D dash cube minus D dash raised to power 4, z equals to 0. For auxiliary equation, putting D equals to n and D dash equals to 1, then equate to 0 the bracket of LHS. So what do we get? M raised to power 4 minus 2m cube plus 2m minus 1 equals to 0. This is a biquadratic equation. So You can solve this type of biquadratic equation by heat and trial method. And by the heat and trial method, we came to know that m equals to 1 is a factor of this particular biquadratic equation. So, when m equals to 1 is a root, so m minus 1 is a factor, then we have to calculate another root or another factor. So, for this, this is a biquadratic equation, so write this particular factor in four times, m minus 1, and m minus 1 equals to 0. Now, we have to balance it by this particular equation. So, this is m, and we have to make this m as m raised to power 4. Then how to make? If we multiply here by n cube, then we get m raised to power 4. So this is m raised to power 4 minus n cube. But we have to find minus 2 n cube. 1 n cube arises and 1 n cube balance. So if we multiply by minus m square in this particular factor, then we can get minus m cube also. So 1 minus n cube from here and 1 minus n cube from here, we get minus 2 n cube and minus plus m square, but no need of m square, this is plus m square, so we have to cancel out this m square, and by multiplying minus m, we can cancel out this m square, this plus m square and this minus m square, and this is minus m, but we have to find minus minus plus m, and we have to find out of 2m. 1 m from here and 1 m from here. So, we shall multiply by 1 here. So, this is balanced, or we can write it as m minus 1 m cube minus m square minus m plus 1 equals to 0. Again, by heat and trial method, to solve this, again we get m minus 1 is also a factor. And from the same type, we solve it, and we get m minus 1, m plus 1 are the another roots. So we get m equals to 1, 1, 1 and minus 1 are the 4 roots. 3 roots are equal and 1 is unequal. So for this, CF is equals to F1 y plus x plus x F2 y plus x square F3 y plus x and F4 y minus x for this unequal root. So this is the complete solution of this particular problem. Now this is another question. Solve the linear partial differential equation del raised to power 4 z over del x raised to power 4 plus del raised to power 4 over del y raised to power 4 equals to 0. In the same putting del over del x equals to d, del over del y equals to d dash, we get d raised to power 4 plus d dash raised to power 4 z equals to 0. For auxiliary equation, putting d equals to m and d dash equals to 1, then equate to 0 the bracket of LHS. So m raised to power 4 plus 1 equals to 0. Now we have to find the solution of this particular biquadratic equation, and to find the root of this particular type of equation, what we have to do here? If minus exists, then we can easily solve the problem, but there is a positive sign, so we have to apply completing square method. So for this, middle term is missing. If there is 2m square, then we can write it as m square plus 1 whole square. So 2m square add and 2m square subtract. So we get m square plus 1 whole square minus root 2m whole square equals to 0. So we can write it as m square plus root 2m plus 1 and m square minus root 2m plus 1 equals to 0. So we have two quadratic equations, and we know how to solve these quadratic equations. We cannot solve these equations directly, so we shall apply quadratic formula, and after applying quadratic formula, m equals to minus 1 plus iota root 2, 1 plus iota upon root 2, minus 1 minus iota upon root 2, and 1 minus iota upon root 2. So, all roots are distinct. So, CF is equals to f1y plus this entire. So we can write it as f1y plus minus 1 plus iota upon root 2x plus f2y plus 1 plus iota upon root 2x plus f3y plus minus 1 minus iota upon root 2x and plus f4y plus 1 minus iota upon root 2x. So these are the possible type of problem where we have to find CF. In the next lecture, we will study PI, particular integral. If you like this lecture, then like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.